Hello and welcome back. More than 53% of McDonald's sales in India comes from the McAloo Tikki and another local products like the McPizza Puff. McAloo Tikki outsells every other McDonald's product in India. It became the face of McDonald's menu innovation in India, and that is how a global brand's local innovation helped them to win the hearts of Indian consumers. Well, then how did McAloo Tikki become the masterstroke in Indian market? After India's economic reforms and liberalization in 1991, many foreign brands were looking to enter India. McDonald's saw a huge potential in India and started preparing its entry plan. To help them understand the tastes and preferences in Indian consumers, McDonald's began looking for Indian joint venture partners. It finally formed joint ventures with two different partners. The market for the West and the South India was targeted through joint venture with Hardcastle restaurants, and the market for North and East India was targeted through joint venture with Connaught Plaza restaurant. Finally, McDonald's opened its stores for public in 1996. In the first 10 to 15 years, the joint venture had a vision to build the foundation of the business and the eating out market, which was absent at that time in India. The strategy was divided into three phases. Phase 1 of the strategy was global phase, where McDonald's was a globally successful brand, but they had to adapt to local Indian situation. However, it faced a big problem at that time. India being a country with so many different cultures and customs, McDonald's had to consider cultural and religious factors in India. Beef and pork being the integral part of the menu for McDonald's in Western countries, it was difficult for the company to formulate a menu without beef and pork items in India. McDonald's initial products in India were burgers, fries, vegetables, nuggets, and beverages, but they had no significant impact on Indian market at that time. Their main agenda was local innovation of the menu. To understand the consumption pattern, they undertook a research. The research in the southern India indicated that 51% of total number of people visiting the restaurants ate non-vegetarian products, whereas in north, this pattern was reversed. 62% of the people preferred vegetarian products. So McDonald's needed a product that could be served in each and every part of India. After a long interval and even further research, they found that potato was the staple diet of every Indian, no matter where they belong. However, it was the year 2001, McDonald's came up with a breakthrough innovation, the Aloo Tikki burger, which was a combination of potato and peas patty with special Indian spices coated with breadcrumbs, served with sweet tomato mayo, fresh onions and tomatoes in a regular bun, which became an instant hit. McDonald's local R&D team put the potato, a traditional Indian taste, inside a bun to create the now trademark product, the Aloo Tikki. McAloo Tikki burger was a unique proposition that brought familiarity of Indian cuisine. Also, it was priced at only Rs. 25, so consumers had a great product at an affordable price. They had a good and stable product. Now in the second phase, which was called the build phase, they had to bring it out to people, increase the stability of the organization, and get the right people on the board. McDonald's faced a lot of problems at that time, like lettuce was not widely available in India, as Indians used cabbage instead. When McDonald's entered the market 17 years ago, it spent 6 years and over 450 crores to set up their supply chain infrastructure. McDonald's also advertised the product aggressively, further fueling its success. The third phase saw the increase in the number of stores, so they called it the grow phase. After the entire control on the product and the market, they started to expand, creating new stores across the country. Globally, McDonald's success had been attributed to think global, act local, and sell like a retailer philosophy. In India, McDonald's chose to localize its menu, keeping in mind the cultural sensitivities and tastes. It has invested in creating products unique to India, such as Maharaja Mac, the most iconic McAloo Tikki burger, McPuff, and many more. Do you know that if you go to Canada, you will find lobster sandwiches on menu? Similarly, in Germany, you can have beer with your food, and in Japan, you can have green tea ice cream, which are some of the examples of local innovation of global brand like McDonald's around the world. Concluding this video with a fun fact. The golden arcs on the McDonald's are said to be most recognized symbol in the world and have played a crucial role in its marketing strategy. So that's all for today. Thanks for watching and supporting us. We'll keep on bringing you with some awesome content. Till then, goodbye and see you in the next video.